Subscribe to Naija's Craziest. Press the bell icon and never miss another video update.
Naija's Craziest is not a review of any political parties, individuals, or religious group. This show is just for comedy purposes only. It might contain scenes with strong languages, strong satirical humor, links to a relative you might know, and references some may find offensive. If that kind of thing will offend you, because close your browser now and
get out of here, man. Shit, I'm saying.
Because Naija, we did.
Comedians are absolutely insane. That is terrible.
Shut up.
Hello guys, welcome to this episode. On this episode, we want to think about wise man Daniel. This man is just a copycat. Is a photocopy of TB Joshua. Copycat. Everything TB Joshua does, he wants
if
to.
If a lion born, what will he born? A lion. He will not born ya. He can never born ya.
So wise man Daniel was trying to tell Christians that it will pay them not to stay in fancy places alone, but they can go to mountain to pray so that God can answer their prayer. They don't have to stay in fancy places. And he felt the need to record himself. My brother, if you are going to mountain to pray, it's not between you and God.
I'll tire.
Now you are trying to show humility. You went to mountain, you decided to bring drone like your master. Your master will bring drone. Bring multiple angle camera.
Different, they will take different shots. And they will not edit.
They will not edit it together. And you say you are in the mountain. You are trying to show humility. So your aunt bite him, man. What? Let's watch.
Yes, viewers all over the world, you can see ants everywhere. This to let you know that we are in the wilderness here in Abuja. So where to sit now is an issue because of these ants. You can see them. If you are not careful, they will sting you. This is it. This shows that you can't find Jesus Christ in the city. Okay? Jesus Christ is not in the city. He's not in the palace. He's in a place like this, a place known as the manger.
Teach us a wrong word, oh. You cannot find Jesus in the city.
Here was a man of God.
Hey! Don't everybody say a man of God.
Sorry. A prophet of native gods.
Hey!
So you cannot find Jesus in the city, but you built a church.
In the city?
In the city. Why didn't you carry your...
Inside the desert. Why can't you build... Oh, okay. Now I get it. Where he built the church, there is no Jesus there. Do you understand? That place where be the church, na shrine.
So Jesus,
that
is,
place
Jesus is in
the bush. Na ide there. So Jesus live for bush. You remember TB Bonchia, TB say, he like a nation. Everything should be nation. You come to this,
I agree with that you need serenity sometimes to concentrate. But don't say that Jesus is not in the city. What do you mean by Jesus is not in the city?
Wait, all your life, where have you been?
I don't understand.
Okay, that means Jesus has not been with you since all your life.
Let's continue.
A place where it takes humility. See, I'm running away. These soldier ants everywhere. Where it takes humility to get to. So that is it. So I'm here this weekend to prepare for Sunday service. And just want to let you know, this is a special announcement. I know many of you are expecting to meet us at the Velodrome this coming Sunday. But the situation on ground demands that we should act as good citizens because we are law-abiding citizens. What makes us good Christians also makes us good citizens. Let us take a scripture to buttress what we're talking about as law-abiding citizens.
See, first of all, if you feel bring that past of Bible that say Jesus not in the city first.
He made another loose statement.
Okay.
He said Jesus exists in a place, a manger.
A manger, no.
Like
he did not.
Like place like this.
Mm-mm.
The only reason why Jesus was born in a manger is because he's coming as a king. So why would people take a king? He's coming to preach to the common man. Now, you are coming to preach to the common man. They will not give birth to you in
the
palace,
or White House.
In the palace then. No, the common man will not relate.
Yes.
So he brought himself down to say, let him give birth to me in a manger.
Yes, so that
let me mix with the common men. But you built your church in the city. Now you are saying as a law-abiding citizen. I don't understand what you mean by law-abiding citizen. Come into bush.
Go bush. Okay, let power look and believe in bush.
Now they are doing close-up shot of ants. They are following the ants. What is all this for? Is it not for show? They are following the ant and showing his leg like this. They say, don't worry, Papa, we'll take close up of your leg.
It's the same thing TB Boncha did that time. We did the video now.
We'll take close up of your leg. Why are you doing like this?
At least one good inform umbubility. I follow what we see in my umbu. That one way, that way,
carrying security.
Let me quickly take you to the book of Romans, chapter 13. From verses 1 to 7. Are you there? Wow, these ants, they are not allowing me to stay. They are not allowing me to stay one place. So bear with me, viewers all over the world. So that is it. Romans 13 and verses 1 to 7. Let everyone be subject to the governing authority, for there is no authority except that which God has established. Take notes. The authorities that exist have been established by God. Consequently, whoever rebels against the authority rebels against what God has instituted. You can see. And those who do so will bring judgment on themselves. For rulers hold no terror for those who do right, but for those who do wrong. Do you want to be free from fear of one in authority? Then do what is right, and you will be commended. For the one in authority is God's servant, for your good. But if you do wrong, be afraid, for rulers do not bear the sword for no reason. They are God's servants, agents of wrath, to bring punishment on the wrongdoer.
There are some parts in the Bible that were put by the ruling class to suppress the people. Now they are saying, this part is saying that obey the authority, because it's God that put them there. Let's take Buhari as case study. You want to tell me that it's God that put Buhari there when people cannot vote?
And their votes will count.
Their votes are taken and burnt, and they just manipulate numbers. So it's God that manipulated the number to put Buhari there.
See, first,
this man, Mugabe, it's God that put Mugabe there for 40 years. You can see what we are saying, the conditioning of the mind.
Mayor, you know the problem. Well, the problem I have at this point is where he is and what he's reading does not have anything.
It does not. Like, what are you doing there? You are standing inside ants and doing like this. And
what are you doing? Something off. Government, obeying government, obeying government. Is it? Does government say you should go to the bush and pray? It does not have. Well, this man, don't know what you are teaching people. You go to the bush and say, it's like you are trying to relate to humble. Say you go to the bush, God is not in this act. I was thinking you want to back it up with something, Bible reference. Now, he now went off saying about government, whatever government, authority, or whatever. It does not have any relationship with where you are.
Viewers all over the world, you have heard it clearly in Romans 13, verses 1 to 7. That what makes us good Christians also makes us good citizens, which is obedient to the law. We are law-abiding citizens. At the Elohim family, we are law-abiding citizens. And I want to use this opportunity to thank the Minister of Sports who had made it possible for us to make use of this velodrome. And we are made to understand that His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari will be having an event there. So therefore, being good citizens and law-abiding ones, we have to also permit them to make use of the place. They allowed us to make use of this place because of love. We also supposed to permit them to make use of it because of love as well. So thank you very much. That's the reason why you are not going to make use of that velodrome this Sunday.
No, what he's trying to do is, he's trying to tell you that the government wants to use the velodrome
Where
he's holding the service. The government want to use. So, they cannot use the velodrome then.
So
why he's here? Why he's coming to preach against because he has contradicted himself now.
Okay.
First of all, he said obey constitutional authority. Then he said he should pray against the forces of darkness because the government needs prayer. That means the government is the forces of darkness, even if they are the constituted authority. Nsogbadiro, you don't have problem with that one. Now, you said the government is not in the city. The government, Jesus is not in the city. Why didn't you come and hold the program here? Why are you fighting? Why are you trying to collect the velodrome in the city from the government to hold the program where Jesus is not in?
He's here now. Why he even come here?
It's because
he become government. He won't use that place. So if government did not use the place, you will not remember to come here. You will not be fooling you can only fool your members. They are zombies. You cannot fool us. We are not foolish. You cannot come here and be telling us the way Jesus stay. Okay, what's not the essence of you? You can't cover himself. He go overtalk one way.
That is overtalk that did it.
You can't say the government wants to use that place. Okay, now when the government use that place where Jesus not there, then go stay where Jesus did. Now when the government don't finish, Jesus will not go back to where Jesus no day. They will not be doing their service.
Where there is no Jesus.
Since when there's no Jesus, start here. Your juju power.
So now Jesus is not there as the government is using there.
Yes.
Jesus is not there.
He's not even there. So Jesus is here now. Let's accept that he will have the immediately finish when he go back to that place. What happened next? Jesus is not there. They will just be doing anything they like in Cana. You see life, see the way you are teaching people. people when they say they go school.
Professors,
they will even listen.
They will be listening to this nonsense. Professors that are scholars.
How do you pampunumpatize them? Pampunumpapize them. Papinupapize. Because that's people fafa. It's people
so,
fafa.
People mama now.
Yes. You can put it together. If anyone talk about the mama, you take a pampunumpatize. You understand? How do you do it and put all of them in one bus and make them think what you are saying is real or is true or you are saying the right thing? People should now wake up in the morning and say, oh, Jesus is not in the city. Let us go to the bush. Why not go desert where strong Amina are dead here? Why not go where the strong animal?
You should go where there is tiger and lion now.
Since Jesus is not in the jungle.
You're in jungle, go. Go, Joshua, let's go. Let's go, Jerry. This one does not know what he's saying. Thank you guys for watching this
episode. Wait, before you go, I will say, Father, forgive him because he does not know
what he's saying. Thank you guys for watching this episode. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, laugh me, and follow Aboki on Joshua on Instagram and Joshua Community, and follow us on our social media. And just kidding. Don't forget, guys, question everything because normal is boring.